Good morning, students. Today we start with the chapter trigonometry. Dear students, we know the unit of measuring any angle is degree measure. Now we'll just see the second unit of measuring the angle, that is known as radian measure. Radian measure. What is radian measure? Radian measure is in a unit circle with center O, OA as radius, the angle subtended at the center by an arc of one unit. Angle subtended at the center by an arc of one unit is said to have an angle 1 radian. 1 radian. Radian is denoted by small c, whereas degree is denoted by O. Now, the relation between this length of arc and the radius. Let's see theta, if it is the angle subtended at the center, L, if length of arc is denoted by L, and R is the radius of a circle, then this is the relation between length of arc, radius, and the angle subtended at the center. So this angle subtended at the center, theta, is the ratio of the length of arc and the radius. The unit of this angle subtended always in radian measure only. Here length of arc and the radius may be in terms of meter or centimeter, but theta must be in radian. Now, in general way, we can say that in a circle of radius r, if angle subtended at the center by an arc of radius r is 1 radian only. So radian measure, that is the angle, always depends on length of arc and the radius, right? Now come to the next point, that is, in a complete revolution, when we check in a circle of any radius r, then complete revolution always subtend an angle 360 at the center, right? So this angle is 360 degree at the center. But the same way, when we use that relation, theta equals to L upon R. So complete revolution means, a complete revolution is the circumference of the circle, and the circumference of the circle is given by 2 pi R of radius r, then the theta is 2 pi radian. In that case, theta is 2 pi radian. But we know that in degree measure, the angle subtended at the center is 360 degree. Thus, we can say that 2 pi is equal to 360 degree, or pi is equals to 180 degree. So it is pi radian and 180 degree. This is a relation between radian measure and the degree measure. So pi radian is always 180 degree. Right? From this relation, we can have two more relations. First is, when we are asking to convert our radian measure into degree measure, then one radian measure is equals to 180 upon pi degree. Means, if we are given radian measure and we are asking to convert it into degree measure, we multiply that angle by 180 upon pi. So this is another relation, and the second relation is, one degree is equals to pi upon 180 radian. We use this relation when we are given, that convert our degree measure into radian measure. Then what we do? We multiply that angle by pi by 180. Let's take one example based on these two, right? Question is, convert degree into radian measure. 15 degree into radian. What we do? 15 multiplied by pi upon 180. This gives you in radian measure. Right? So it is 15.1. So the result is pi upon 12 radian. So this is the conversion of 15 degree into radian. So 15 degree is same as pi upon 12 radian. Right? If you are asking to convert radian measure into degree measure, then you have to see two more things. First is, when we convert any radian measure into degree, then we have to go with their subunits. Subunits means 1 degree is always equals to 60 minutes. Minutes is denoted by 1 dash, and 1 minute is equals to 60 seconds. Seconds is denoted by 2 dash, double dash. Right? So whenever you are asking to convert a radian measure into degree measure, we have to convert into degree measure with their subunits, that is minutes and seconds. Let's see one example based on this. Question is, convert say pi upon 4 radian into degree measure. Pi upon 4 into degree measure. So what we do? Pi by 4 multiplied by 180 upon pi. So after cancelling pi, it gives 45 degree. So pi by 4 radian is 45 degree. Right? Now take another example. If it is convert 6 radian into degree measure, 6 radian into degree measure, then we follow this following steps. First, convert degree radian measure into degree measure by multiplying pi upon 180 upon pi. Now this gives you in degree. Now next step is put the value of pi as 22 upon 7. So 22 upon 7, when we solve it gives 6 180, 7 upon 22. After simplifying, it is 3780 upon 11. This is in degree measure, but we have to convert it up to its subunits, right? So 3780 when divided by 11, we get 343 and the remainder as 7. Question 343, remainder 7. Now what we do, this 343 gives you degree, 343 degree. Now whatever remainder you have, you multiply it by 60 to convert degree into minutes. So